Celebrate this truth that we find there and hear our lives to it. So right now, let's just commit all of ourselves to Him. Yeah. to see all y'all today here at Summit Church. Thank you so much for making us a part of your day, and I hope your day is going well so far. And just a few quick announcements. As many of y'all know, we are having a marriage, not a marriage here at Summit, February 27th. We've got the sign up in the back of the room. If you've not signed up, if you've not bought your tickets, you need to do so, especially guys today, if you've not bought your tickets after the message today. Show your wife you're going back there to buy those tickets. It probably means something. All right, so that's going to be February 27th, a big night of marriage, and we're looking forward to that. Also, we got the D-Now coming up next Friday. This is for our teenagers. If you're here, you're a teenager, and you've not signed up, you need to sign up, and if you're going to be there, you and your parents need to meet over here following our service. It's free, thank you. It is free, it won't cost you anything, it'll be some good food. And speaking of which, we did need some people to donate some food. And make sure it is good food. So anyway, you want to go over there too and be in on that. Tonight we're going to have another edition of our Summit University. We're going to look at an Old Testament survey tonight. What exactly is in the Old Testament, how is it structured. What's a good way that I can look at the Old Testament and kind of get a good working knowledge so when I read something in the prophets or read something in the book of Genesis, how does it all relate together? We're going to look at that tonight. Also, if you're here and you're a first-time visitor with us, we've got a guest card at the bottom of the handout you received. If you'd fill out that guest card, put a little bit of information about yourself, we'd like to be able to shoot you an email, have a connection with you that way. And we're just delighted that you have all chosen to be here today. We're going to take time now to go to God in prayer and ask His blessings upon this day. We've prepared ourselves to be here. You've gotten up this morning. You've eaten breakfast, hopefully. You've dressed nice, and you've gotten here today. And let's not make this a wasted hour. Let's make this very, very meaningful. So that means we've got to clear our minds of distractions. We've got to lay aside any idols or anything in our life that's kind of between us and God right now so we can hear what God wants to speak to us this morning and that our will would be in such a way that we would respond yes to whatever God says today. Okay? So let's pray together. Dear God, thank you for just the opportunity of a day. Lord, to be alive, to enjoy creation, to have relationships with other people. Lord, to be able to be in a place like this, to live in a country that we live in, where we have freedom of assembly, where we have freedom of religion. We can come together, we can assemble together, we can worship you, and we don't have to worry about somebody coming in and shutting us down. And we look all around the world and we see nations where there's so much turbulence. There's so much discord and disharmony in nations. Yet we are privileged to live in the nation that we live in. We thank you so much for that. Lord, as we have prepared ourselves to be here, I pray our hearts now would be prepared. Lord, especially as we're going to address the guys today, what a husband should be like, how a husband should treat his wife. I pray for the husbands that are here that, Lord, that they would have ears to hear. God, any obstacles that are in their lives, any preconceived notion, Lord, that they would just have a true desire to want to seek you. To seek your will, to look into your word, and God, to adjust their lives accordingly. And we pray for Philip and the band, just anoint them. Lord, help them as they lead us in worship, that we truly worship you from our hearts, that it wouldn't just be meaningless words that we read off the screen, but Lord, that our heart would connect with what we read and what we sing. And we pray and ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let me say, louder than creation to you, for the pain you bore in your body, bring my soul to you. Let me shine. Need of your heart for
away.
Thank you that we can praise you. you and that we can come together like this, Lord, as one body and just worship you for your wonder and your splendor, God. And thank you so much for your grace and for your mercy and everything that you've done for us on the cross, Lord. Just let us lift up your name in this place and let us always apply your word to our lives.
I will fall at your feet. Always smiling, but only